first and foremost, just your thoughts on the match tonight.
I need to start with before the game today. I've been a coach for head coach for 15 years. It's probably around 600 games. But today was probably the most difficult one. We had four players from the start 11, a game day, that couldn't play. Three of them because of illness and fever, and one because of a COVID situation. Rebecca Holloway, that was traveling from Europe. In the game, of course, when you need to change so much, like four times, it's extremely difficult. So from that, normally I want to win a home game against Houston, but the fighting spirit, everything they do today, the goals, I'm extremely proud of them. In the end, I think we are the better team. We have like 60% in possession. We create more chances. We can see even if they score the first goal, we keep fighting. We score the equalizer, and we keep going for the winner. So that was all I can ask for the team today. I'm extremely proud of them.
What was your view of Jess's goal, how that played out?
Yeah, I mean, there's something that's really important for us. She is one of the best players in this league in the air, so we need to use her more often in the air. So that was a good one, both for us and for her.
Was it? It had to be a proud moment for you that Amina's pressure in the attacking third created it.
Absolutely. I mean, Amina, she always comes in with so much energy. So it's really nice to have her on the bench ready to go in, and yeah, especially here in the home game of some reason.
Kim, you gonna get some of these players back by next week? What's the situation there?
Yeah, I mean, we follow the league's protocol, so I don't know with the COVID test how long time it's gonna take, or I think at least a couple of the players will be back. But you never know. They have fever yesterday or tonight and this day, and normally you have fever in maybe 2 days or something like that. So I really hope they can be back as soon as possible, but today I don't know.
How much time before the match did you know that Simon know before she was going to start? Aaron Simon, looks like she was all, if Gemma was a late scratch, how much time before Simon knew she was going to be in the match?
I mean, it was not that much. She was like, the first one came like 2 o'clock, the second one 5 o'clock, the third one 5:30, and number four like 6 o'clock or something like that. So, I mean, there have been, yeah, a busy day. Yeah.
So you talk a little bit about Simon's performance, just kind of, you know, she's not a center back by nature. She hasn't played a ton this year, but what do you think of her performance tonight before she went?
I mean, it was, I'm proud about both Simon and Merrick. To be honest, yeah, they haven't played that much. They have been always in the team that play against the start 11. So they have played together for at least 1 month or something like that. So I was not so worried about that because, yeah, they have worked together for 1 month. Even if it's not been in the start 11, even if it's not been in the Challenge Cup or in the league. So I think they did really well. Yeah.
And then Simon obviously came off. Was that illness or injury related?
I think she was struggling with a cramp. Yeah.
Second tie in regular season. We had a few of them in the Challenge Cup. Do you feel like there's something missing with the team that can, you know, maybe go toward turning games like this in the wins, or is it just maybe bad luck?
Today we miss a good preparation for players. So I think. And still, we are the better team today. Like I said, there's 60% of the ball, crosses, more chances, everything. I mean, that's what you're doing in the week. You prepare the team for the game, and now we couldn't do it. I mean, because everything changed with just a few hours. Like I said, and first time in maybe 600 games as a coach. So it's a crazy day.